Hair grease. This is something that they've told us to stay away from for forever, but this and several other unconventional practices have completely transformed my hair. Today, I'm sharing all the secrets with you all so your hair will finally grow. Be sure to thumbs up because this is going to be an amazing ride. And while you all are here, I might as well tell you to follow me on Instagram and Twitter so you can follow my journey with hair grease and ask me any questions you might have about the things I'm about to share with you all in this video. Now, without any further ado, let's get right into the video. Hey Z-Stars, what's good in the hood? It's your girl Zara, aka FXR, and welcome back to another video. I hope you all enjoyed that intro. I'm trying something new. If you've never been here before, welcome. This is my channel. We have a lot of fun here. Now, since we've already been over exactly what we're going to talk about, I won't waste you all's time. Let's get right into the video. Now, before we do, please be sure to give this video one big thumbs up. Be sure to share it to all of your friends and your loved ones. Comment down below, let me know what your own hacks are. And last but never ever least, be sure to subscribe to my channel and turn your notifications on so you know every time I post a new video. Now I'm gonna give you a few moments to subscribe. Cue the Jeopardy music. Okay, so you should be subscribed and your notifications should be on. Let's get straight into this. Hair grease. This is definitely the craziest one. Now, we've been taught by the natural hair community for more than a decade to totally avoid grease. Now, I'm very certain that this rhetoric comes from a lot of these large natural hair companies that want to sell us their very expensive products, as opposed to us buying $2 to $3 Blue Magic, Do Grow, etc., etc., etc. Now, the rhetoric behind hair grease is that petrolatum dries out the hair, and it's literally from fossil fuel, so why should we put it in our hair? However, petrolatum is an exceptional sealant. So is mineral oil, which is another component of many greases and problematic hair lotions. Because grease does not allow anything to cross its barrier, it can be very damaging if used incorrectly. However, if your hair is deep conditioned and moisturized adequately, then there's no reason why hair grease should not be extremely effective for you. Now, when I use hair grease, I shampoo my hair in particular with a sulfur shampoo because I deal with itchy scalp and fungal and bacterial overgrowth, aka dandruff. So as opposed to struggling my life, I use a sulfate shampoo with sulfur inside. Following that, I condition my hair and I deep condition. I make sure to avoid silicones when I'm using these types of products. Now, I'm fine with dimethicone since it's water soluble, but other types of cones I avoid. Now, the reason I do avoid them is because I'm already going to use an extremely potent sealant in my final step, so there's no reason for me to cake on a lot of product. Now, following my conditioning, deep conditioning, and shampoo process, I make sure to use a generous amount of a high quality leave-in. Now, that's a leave-in that's not going to sit on top of my hair, but actually penetrate the hair shaft, delivering moisture to the deepest reaches of my cortex. Now, can anything actually cross the cortex? If you guys know about hair science, let me know in the comments down below. But basically what I'm just trying to say is that I use a moisturizer that's going to penetrate my hair shaft really well and keep my hair moisturized for days on end, even without the use of a sealant as powerful as hair grease. Now, of course, after that, I apply my handy dandy hair grease, which I love so much. My personal favorite is Do Grow, and I'll give a link to the one that I use down below. I also really enjoy Blue Magic, but I prefer the scent of Do Grow, so that's the one I frequent. On my scalp, I use Sulfur 8 hair grease. That's really fantastic for me, and it's been keeping my itchies at bay, been keeping my dry scalp away, and been controlling any fungus or bacteria that might be trying to pop up and give your girl some dandruff. Now, the next super secret hair hack is to shampoo and exfoliate your scalp, especially if you're going to be using a sealant as heavy as hair grease. Now, even if you're not using hair grease, you should be doing this because your hair will thank you for it, and I'm going to explain why. Now, my scalp in particular is extremely, extremely sensitive. It abhors tension, and it's prone to dryness. Now, because my scalp is all of these things at once, including very tender, if I leave certain products on my scalp like conditioner, it will cause all sorts of horrible reactions. Burning sensation, itching, redness, etc., etc., etc. Long story short, it's not cute. Aside from that, if I'm yanking at my scalp anyhow, or I allow it to get dry, it's going to definitely flake and give me issues. Now, for me, shampooing and exfoliating have been a saving grace. Now, I know a lot of you are very familiar with shampooing, but are you familiar with exfoliating your scalp? If you're not, I'm going to get you familiar because this is going to completely revolutionize your hair game. Now, personally, I absolutely do not believe in co-washing. I am not a member of the Church of Co-washing. I detest co-washing. And I literally just explained to you all that when I apply conditioner to my scalp and it remains on my scalp, it causes all sorts of horrendous issues for me and my hair, which I'm just not ready to deal with. So, co-washing is a big no for me. My philosophy about why co-washing is extremely ineffective as the only method for cleansing the hair is it can be equated to using fabric softener to wash your clothing. An agent that is meant to condition your hair cannot cleanse your hair. However, if that agent is a cleanser with conditioning properties, cool, that's fine and dandy. Shampooing your scalp is so important because if there's buildup around and inside of your hair follicles, then your hair will not be able to grow properly. What shampooing does is to remove debris, dirt, fungus, bacteria, and any other obstructions in your hair follicles. If your hair follicles are free of all of those agents, your hair will grow uninhibited, unobstructed, and as quickly and full and thick as it could possibly grow. Now, in case that was long-winded, let me be clear. A scalp that is clean and clear will promote hair growth to the best of your body's ability. Now, of course, we did talk about exfoliating, and I'm going to talk to you more about it because at times shampooing is simply not enough, especially for someone like me who has a dry scalp. I need to exfoliate regularly in order for my scalp to be happy and healthy. The same way you exfoliate your body, which is skin, you should also be thinking about exfoliating your scalp. Now, there are several ways to exfoliate the scalp. You can use a scalp brush. Now, there's the manual variant as well as the electric variant. I personally prefer to use the electric variation when I'm massaging my scalp because I cannot come and kill myself to be like going like this all the time. No, it's too much work. Let me get a tool that does it for me. And I literally just place it especially in the front of my head because ultimately those vibrations will reach the back of your head. That's number one. And if you're waking up the blood vessels in a certain region of your head and you continue to massage that area, it will also wake up the other blood vessels in other regions of your head. At least this is the science that I was introduced to. You guys, correct me if I'm wrong. Now, the manual variation is the one I like to use in the shower and gently, very gently scrub my scalp. Now, the best part is a lot of them are made out of silicone, the bristles are. So it gets in there and scrubs the scalp, exfoliating it, lifting dirt, debris, dead skin, etc., without irritating your scalp, which obviously for me, a sensitive skin, natural hair babe, is really, really fantastic. Another way is by using a salt and oil mixture. Now, I like to use salt and olive oil. Now, the reason why this is extremely effective is because a lot of the buildup on your scalp comes from oils. Not just the sebum that your body naturally produces, but also the oils that you're applying to your scalp daily. Now, that mixes and mingles with the dirt and the debris, clogging your pores and creating obstructions for your hair follicles, which is not cute. The salt dislodges those obstructions and the oil dissolves the oil. Now, another method is a soft toothbrush with a conventional shampoo. I really like this method because it's super stress-free and I feel like I'm getting in there really, really well because I'm using a toothbrush and covering every surface of my scalp with a shampoo, which is also cleansing my scalp as I'm doing it. Now, I don't do this method very often either because it is a bit tedious, but if you need a deep clean, I would recommend doing this method before the other ones. The final method is using an exfoliating shampoo. Now, I know of a few. You guys will see some of their pictures pop up right now. I'm also going to list them in the description box down below so you can purchase them. And I'm going to talk about why I like certain ones over others. When you're choosing a shampoo or exfoliating shampoo, it's super important to make sure that you use one with surfactants, y'all. I like to use a straight up sulfate shampoo. Like, I can't come and kill myself. We've been over this already because it cuts through grease. Other surfactants are typically not as effective, and I haven't had much luck with moisturizing shampoos or shampoos that have other surfactants. Now, I do have this black soap shampoo, which is super effective and strips my hair, and it cuts through grease even better than my sulfate shampoo. So I'm going to look into that, and maybe we'll talk about why that is in another video. If you guys would like that, comment down below and let me know, because right now I don't know. I gotta do my research. Now, black soap is also really clarifying for the skin. If you have trouble using it on your skin because your skin is sensitive, maybe try it on your scalp. out. Now I can't use black soap on my face. It's a bit too harsh, but I can use it on my scalp with a lot of success. And my hair absolutely loves my black soap, and it gets the grease all the way out of my scalp and my hair, y'all. Like, it's really impressive.
Hey, my Z stars. So before we move on to the next point, I have a few questions for you all. What are your thoughts on hair grease? Share them in the comments down below. Do you use a sulfate or sulfate-free shampoo? And why? Please let me know in the comments down below. What is your scalp like and how do you keep it healthy? Is it dry? Is it oily? Is it prone to dandruff or anything else? Please let me know. Okay, let's get back to the video. I'm excited to see what you guys have to say.
Eat a diet rich in complete proteins. Y'all, hair is made of protein. It only makes sense that you would need to consume a lot of protein in order for your body to supply it to your hair, your skin, and your nails. If the body doesn't have enough protein, your hair and your nails in particular will be the first to demonstrate signs of protein deficiency. Now, that's because they are non-vital. Your body does not actually need hair and nails to survive. Now, they are beneficial in certain ways, but it's more of a vanity thing. So when it comes to choosing what's gonna get cut off first, it's definitely your hair and your nails. Now, the side effects of protein deficiency are hair thinning, brittle nails, faded hair color, and hair loss. Now, these symptoms are unlikely to appear unless you have a severe protein deficiency. But let's not get there. Let's consume a diet rich in complete proteins. Now, I'm a vegan and I actually take a protein supplement and I really like it. It tastes really good. It's Vega One. I'm gonna put it down in the description box below. And if you guys would actually like a video on all the supplements I take to ensure that my hair is really sexy, let me know. I will definitely be glad to share that with all of you. And since I've been on my supplement regimen, I've actually seen a huge difference in the quality of my hair. Now, digression aside, let's move on to the next one. Make sure you balance your protein and moisture. Now, I'm extremely protein sensitive, like extremely protein sensitive, but I still use a protein conditioner, a very mild one, though I also use henna. These are my two strengthening treatments. Too much protein produces straw-like hair that is dry, rough, prone to breakage, and has really poor elasticity. Too much moisture produces hair that is very mushy, has poor structural integrity, poor elasticity, and is prone to breakage once again. Now, having the perfect balance of protein and moisture ensures that your hair will be strong and healthy, but at the same time, soft, shiny, and well nourished. Now, when it comes to using a protein conditioner, my personal favorite is Opry Organics GPB Glycoprotein Balance. Is that correct? I believe it is. Well, whatever the case may be, it's in the description box down below. I'll also include the video that I feature that product in, as well as my other favorite products, right up here for you guys to check out. Now, I haven't updated in a while, so let me know in the comment section down below if you'd like me to update, especially since I've added a lot of new products and added some greases. So I'm gonna make this video more comprehensive. Just let me know, please. I've actually been using that Opry Organics product since I went natural. And I've been natural for, wow, more than 10 years. I just got chills. That's so crazy. I've been natural for more than 10 years. So I've been using it for that long and it's never ever forsaken me. Moisturize your scalp, please and thank you. Now, this may be a little weird for some people, especially because I literally just spoke about how conditioner on my scalp makes my scalp go crazy. But I'm not talking about applying a leave-in or a cream moisturizer to your scalp. I'm literally talking about applying water mixed with a little bit of tea tree oil to your scalp. It's really, really nourishing, a nice refresher, and keeps the fungus and bacteria at bay. Moisturizing the scalp is especially helpful for those of you that live in a drier climate and also have a dry scalp. Now, ding, 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 both of those are me, so you best believe I'd be moisturizing my scalp every other blessed day. Now again, my scalp is desert dry, y'all. If I do not add water to my scalp is like, girl, you hate us. Like, I'm sure it also has something to do with the fact that I live in an extremely dry climate. But yeah, it's really just not cute. I've never been one of those babes that be producing a heck ton of sebum. However, I will do my research and figure out if I could change that. Now again, in your spray bottle, put purified water and tea tree only, please and thank you. Other products can cause your hair to grow fungus, and that's not cute. Now following that moisturization, I like to apply my grease or a light hair oil, and that just keeps the moisture sealed into my scalp. Wear cornrows for extended periods of time. Now, I'm pretty sure I talked about this in my Grow Your Hair Without Doing Anything video, which I'm going to link right here for you all to check out. Now, I literally talked about a whole bunch of ways to grow your hair without stressing yourself. It's the Lazy Naturals Guide to Success. But the reason I'm mentioning it again is because it's been a huge secret for my hair growth and retention. Now, this kind of style is exceptional for retaining length because your hair is 110% tucked away. Your ends are not exposed. Now, if you are wearing straight backs, your ends are going to be exposed. But I don't do straight backs when I wear cornrows. I do the kinds of cornrows that tuck your ends into other braids within the pattern. Now, a lot of people in my previous videos, when I talk about cornrows, have complained about matting and locking, etc., etc., etc. But it's very easy to avoid that. This is what you have to do. You have to make sure you start on a really good, clean foundation. The braids have to be nice and taut, not tight, very, very neat. And you have to cleanse your hair regularly, or else your hair will definitely accumulate a lot of buildup that is just not cute. Now, I did touch on my braid pattern a little bit, and my hair is extremely thick. So even though straight backs work well for me, I can't do them or else my hair is not gonna fit under any of my waves. So I do a certain braid pattern that's specifically for a thick hair. Again, it tucks my hair in, but it's not your typical braid and tuck method. It's a modified version, which I can show you all if you want to see. Let me know in the comments down below. Now, that foundation for me is a recipe for growth because not only is it very neat, like I said, my ends are tucked all the way away. So everything I'm growing is being retained. If I'm moisturizing my hair, washing my hair, doing what I normally do to my hair, which is to wash, deep condition, and moisturize and seal, then I should be retaining every little bit of length. So y'all, I need to still do my cornrow challenge, and I will, but it's kind of difficult to keep cornrows because aside from the fact that I enjoy having my hair out, people want to see my hair out, you guys, and then brands want to see my hair out. But I'm going to do this 3-month challenge and tell everybody to just chill out so that we can do this experiment together, and I can show you all how beneficial cornrows can be when you're trying to grow your hair to extreme lengths. Positive affirmations and prayer. Now, this one is the most important to me. If you want to do anything in life, you need to speak positively about it and dream about it, as well as dwell on it. Now, this probably sounds like super new age or whatever, but your girl's not even into that stuff, nor do I endorse it. My beliefs are very separate from that of new age. I do, however, believe that it is a spiritual principle that what you think, what you believe is what you become. As a person thinks, so is that person ultimately. So if you dwell on something, if you believe in something, if you believe you will have that thing, you will definitely have it. If you speak about it, you will definitely have it. Life and death are in the power of the tongue. So for me, affirming positively, dwelling on good and positive things, dreaming about what it is that I want my life to be, has been a major key for me actually achieving the things I want to achieve. Now, Jim Carrey had a check of $5 million, I believe. I heard the story from one of my favorite influencers, and he was carrying it around with him for a few years. Now, he was very confident that one day he would be able to cash that check, and one day he did. Why did he achieve that? Because he dwelled on it. He did not relinquish that idea. He refused to let go of it until it actually occurred in his life. And that's a mentality that I personally feel a lot of us as Black people do not really take a hold of. And we need to. It's something that would move our community forward immensely, the power of positive thinking and positive speech. We really need to tap into that. Now, I'm going to give you some examples of affirmations that you can recite in order to ensure that you actually achieve your hair goals. You should definitely apply this to other areas of your life, but for now, of course, we're going to focus on hair since that's what our video is about. My hair is long, my hair is healthy, my hair is thick and shiny, my hair grows quickly. I love my hair is full of beauty and glory. My hair is strong and unbreakable. Now, these are just a few affirmations you all can use. Whatever you want your hair to be, speak it into existence. That is so important. And for me, speaking positively about my hair has been a game changer as far as what it's able to accomplish. Whew, guys, now that was quite the doozy. I hope you enjoyed that video. These are all things that have really made a difference in my hair and my life. Try these unconventional things. I guarantee you'll see a huge difference in the quality of your health and your hair. Please be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Be sure to share it with all of your friends and your loved ones. Comment down below again, letting me know what hacks you guys have for me. Some super secret ones that we can use to help one another. And last but never ever least, subscribe to my channel and turn your notifications on so you know every time I post a new video. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Thank you, I love you, and God bless you. I'll see you in the next video, but of course, stay tuned until after the credits so you can see more of my videos. Ta-ta for now.